On the one hand, I feel self-conscious that I'm keeping, well, that's the regular stuff. The guy who's been trying to get me to leave understands humanity enough that he has referred to this as the shrine, but it's not. But there are some things that belong to my late husband here. Anyway, I pointed them out in a previous video, and I didn't actually point the camera at the right stuff because it was flipped. Anyway, I think that my late husband's stuff, including our short test, we love you, Claude Steiner, Y2K bug, haha. I am someday gonna sell this on eBay or whatever people do now. But I think his stuff is beautiful, and it points out that this is not a boarding house. This is was the home of Claude Steiner, and it was left to my older than me stepdaughter and stepson to be part of his legacy, not to just disappear into nobody remembers who the founder of this household was. He was a rogue man. He had so many sexual liberation, freedom, sexual freedom, liberation group, whatever, parties in the hot tub area, orgies, really, as he would have himself said and did, that the people next door thought he was, this was my late dad's rug, wasn't it? Yeah, sure was. Thought he was running a brothel. Anyway, that's my dude, 22 years here together. Most of it in this house and in the place in Ukiah. I remember I set up some of these things, and somebody, a friend of his, said, "Who's into Mother Mary?" And I was like, "This is quite Kuan Yin, not Qui-Gon Jinn. That's a Batman thing." And I was like, "This is not Mother Mary stuff, most of it." And he was like, "Yeah, but Mother Goddess, right?" And I was like, "Well, and Nymph Goddess, because a lot of these ladies are not necessarily moms." This woman sounds just like the wonderful Billie Holiday. I can kind of sing like her. Well, we've got bugs. Jane Austen, that's a thing of mine. We watched all of Mad Men together. My current fiance and I really understand Mad Men together most of the time, in agreement, certainly in agreement, how much we love it. This is Claude's one of his first books. Something we got in Japan that I only just now recovered. Ditto our key to the hotel in Siwataneha. I guess I need more than one video of these things, because the other one got respectable views, but Sistema in Siwataneho, Mexico. Pues, adios. Adios, mis amigos y los amigos de Claudio. Pardon me. Esto es Claudio totalmente. Este es con black leather and dark wood. Oh, he had a cabinet where he kept, what did he call it? Not libations, but, liqueurs, like Cointreau, always Cointreau. He was really big into tequila, and he told me that he took the front off of it and carried it around with him to, Ann Arbor and California and back and forth for years, and then had a case rebuilt to go with it. And I was like, "You carried it that long, really?" And he said, "Yep. Well, when I see something good, I know it and I hold on to it." So that was a very sweet and loving thing that my late husband said. And of course, he was said it with a wink, a wink of a winking sort of smile. And I knew he was talking about me. And that was very sweet and lovely of him to say. I have no idea where that thing is now. I remember I tried to make a video of it with the clothes he was gonna wear when they were gonna, cremate him, that he was planning to have done, and wear a brown Mexican style shirt. And somehow I was new to the video process and it didn't work out and didn't happen. Okay, let me show you guys one more thing. I'm afraid to press pause because who knows what'll happen. I actually got a screenshot or something, a thumbnail on my screen. These are Claude's books that he wrote. Ta-da! I didn't give him enough time last time. I let Eric and his sister keep the Claude Steiner thing. Reminds me of Claude's. His ex used to, and his daughter used to joke that when he said Claude Steiner with his accent, it sounded like Claude's Diner, which is funny because on Steiner Street in San Francisco, there's a great diner. I think it's called Zim's, which reminds me, like I said last time, of Biff's Is the Place Where the Cool Hang Out, which is a song about East Oakland. I love diners that are open all night, the high-end ones and the low-end ones. Look at all the books that my late husband wrote and all the videos that he made. Where are the videos? Hey, where are the videos? Well, I have some of them. I know they are somewhere. Anyway, amazing amount. They don't give authors as many of their books, copies of their books, as you think they do. When an author gives you a copy of his book, that's a compliment. That means he cares about your opinion and connecting with you, because he doesn't have enough copies. Okay, everybody. Thank you so much for listening. Bye. I think I'm going to make a chat group. Seems like they don't want me in the forum for therapists because they don't like my candor. Haha, candor channel. So I think I'm going to make a chat group for people who are interested in psychology and psychotherapy in all shapes and sizes. Claude had a lot of beautiful ancient books like that. Maybe I need to have that one. I'll talk to Eric about it. Oh, Eric is... But when long ago, when Claude was a younger man, at the height of his prime, that was his son, Eric. For those of you who are into the Enneagram, that is a portrait of a 8 with 7, sex dom 8 with 7, and a probably self-preservational dom 9 with 1. Claude thought that this was his spirit animal, the wolf. And he loved nude female dancers, so yes, he did. He wrote a beautiful thing, a kind of prose poem for me when I first moved in, because I was listening to some of my music, like maybe Joy Division or Jane's Addiction or who knows what, and he wrote a prose poem like, who is this blonde-haired nymph dancing so rambunctiously or raucously or something in my lair, hair flowing. I bought this for him, and then I couldn't find it, and then I gave it to him. About several months, maybe 4 months before he passed away. I bought it on Berkeley's beautiful Solano Avenue, where I used to work during a very dark time in my life, when Claude and I were separated, but he eventually started helping because my dad was fighting a losing battle with cancer. Guan Yin, she is the goddess of kindness, although her story is weird, pretty codependent. Anyway, Claudio... I was there the day that picture was taken, and they took a beautiful picture of us. I'll share that with you, too, sometime. Bye, everybody. Well, maybe I can do that now. Let's see. No, I'm just going to... My poems are published in this journal. Maybe not that issue. This is my collection of poetry journals, and I am published in a number of them. And that's our marriage certificate there. Where am I published? Here's the ones that I've been published in. And Laura Tillery, and this is the lady I used to babysit for. She is the guest editor for New Poets. Elizabethan, like my birthday. My birthday. I share my birthday with Beethoven, not Shakespeare. Okay. Claude stuff. There's a big issue about clutter, and do I have too much clutter in the house? But I'm proud of this clutter, kind of, because look how beautiful it is. What an amazing aesthetic my Claudio had. Such a wonderful mix of the heavy, dark... Mexican alpha male, special kind of macho, alpha Mexicano, macho de Mexicano, with, look at this whimsy. Everywhere in Ciudad you see this motif. Diego Rivera has it too. Look, that is both a wonderful mixture of the feminine, and Diego Rivera was in many ways a very masculine guy. Gave that to Claude for his 70th, but I gave him a big framed, actually mounted, my friend from high school's parents own a place where you can mount any work of art, any poster, and it looks like an original painting. Claudio. There is Claudio. Bye, everybody. Bye. The Candor Channel. Wouldn't have been possible without my late husband, Claude Steiner. My new fiancé made the suggestion that if I related to YouTube so much, I should have my own YouTube channel. And I was like, I'm not a video essayist. I don't think I want to be that. But, you know, without Claude's support and encouragement, I would never have gotten there. Thank you, Claudio. Thank you. Siwatanejo. Brisas del Mar. He said that inside of this was a shirt for me, and he said that he hoped he would see me, that he would never see me wear it in the sun, but he hoped I would, and now I'm going to cry. So I'm going to stop. Sign of the times. I left a rotting plum. Claudio. Claude Michel Steiner. Claudio mi cachorrito. Claudio. Claude M. Steiner. Claudio. Cachorrito.